Hello and welcome back to Teacher Cast. My name is Jeff and we are live here at FETC. I am with the team from Minecraft Education from Microsoft. How are things?
Great, thanks Jeff. I'm Susie.
And I'm Maria.
And today we're talking all about Minecraft Education and what it's doing in the classroom. But I know there's a lot of new things and new features. So let's just start off. What is new in Minecraft Education?
Yeah, so in our latest update, we just released our library. So we're actually taking all six subject kits that we have on the website and actually embedding them in game. So we're taking our most popular lessons. We have 500 lessons in a variety of subjects on our website and actually pulling them in our six different subject kits. So teachers can actually go to the library, pick a lesson, and actually have it already preloaded, and students can get that as well, which is really exciting. And then with the library update, we also did some really fun things about Hour of Code, which Maria can talk about.
So with the Hour of Code, the exciting part is that right now our demo account is available. So what does it mean? It means that anybody right now, even now, can go ahead and download Minecraft, install it on your device, and go and try a coding lesson with Minecraft Education Edition. You don't need to log in, you don't need an account, you don't need a password. Go and give it a try. And this lesson teaches students how to save a village from fire with AI for good.
We certainly like using all the great stuff that Minecraft has to offer on code.org, and of course they're great games, but it's not just a platform for exploring. Tell us a little bit about how kids are really deep diving not only into the land, but into the aquatic, but space also?
Yes.
Do you want to? Yeah, last year we did a partnership with NASA and created the International Space Station, which is really exciting. Nice. Students can explore and actually create another part of the station and label the different parts that they learn about, really focusing on those assessment pieces like using the camera and slates to write the different parts of the space station. So yeah, we've done a really lot of cool partnerships over the last couple of years.
Yeah, I think to add on top of this, I think Minecraft is really good at interdisciplinary approach. So everything cross-curricular, plus creativity, plus problem solving, plus critical thinking. So everything, all the goodness that Susie was talking about, together with building, makes life much better.
Now, many teachers are looking at Minecraft and saying, how do I get started, right? Once you're into the ecosystem, there's a lot of things that you can do in your classrooms, but talk to us a little bit about how do we get started. What's the first thing a teacher needs to do or have available for them?
Yeah, I think one of the best things to get started is we have a course on the Microsoft Educator community called My Minecraft Journey. It does a really good job of going over what is game-based learning, why it's important in the classroom, and how to get started with Minecraft Education Edition. And in addition to that, we have a lot of awesome build challenges that are really easy for teachers to get started with. Quick 30, 45 minute activities that are really easy to introduce a classroom that has not used Minecraft Education Edition before.
But also we have First Lesson Kit, which is awesome for new educators. You can download the First Lesson Kit and it will teach you all the stuff about game-based learning, but also give you ideas of how to get started. How do I load the world? How do I get students in? How do I get the first lesson on digital citizenship? And how do I progress with Minecraft Education Edition?
Now, if there's one thing I know about Minecraft, it is all about the community. And here we are at FETC, one of the largest conferences in the planet, and you're having an opportunity to see thousands, tens of thousands of educators. The feedback must be amazing. When you're on the floor here, what kind of things are you hearing from teachers? How are they using it in their classrooms?
Yeah, I think one of the biggest stories that we hear is just how Minecraft can be an inclusive tool in the classroom. Mm-hmm. I think one of the most popular stories we hear is how those students that don't typically excel in the normal classroom environment, when they're given the opportunity to use a tool like Minecraft that they play at home and they're very comfortable and familiar with, they actually can come out of their shell. We hear a lot of the times that it's their first time being able to communicate and connect with other students in their class and really become the leaders, which is really great for us to hear, to have that student advocacy and voice for sure.
We also hear a lot about engagement. So from the research that we just completed in Australia, we did a research on math in grades 3 and 4. And what we were looking for is learning outcomes. What kind of learning outcomes are actually being brought by Minecraft Education Edition. And what we learned is that students identified themselves as better math learners with Minecraft. And also teachers noted that the students would be engaged for a very long period of time. So up to 2 hours, students would be engaged in talking about math through Minecraft, which is super exciting for us to hear.
I love the fact that Minecraft can be used for any age, any subject. I even know some six-year-olds that are playing Minecraft right now, and it's amazing to see. Where do you see Minecraft going in the future? We're all looking forward to ISTE. What can you give us as far as a scoop for 2020?
Yeah, so I'll let Maria talk a little bit about what's coming in regards to computer science. But just recently, Minecraft was named the most popular video game of all time. Minecraft as a franchise has 180 million monthly users, which is insane to think about. So we're only hoping that Education Edition gets bigger and bigger as Minecraft just expands as well.
The scoop for us for computer science is Python is coming into the game. So right now, when you go into the world and press C, you can start coding immediately. And we usually pick MakeCode as our platform of choice for coding. So with MakeCode, what is available is lessons in block-based coding and lessons in JavaScript. And now we're working on bringing Python into the game.
That will be a game changer for so many students. For anybody that's interested in learning more about Minecraft or bringing it into their classrooms, where can we go to learn more information?
Yeah, you can visit our website at education.minecraft.net.
Or go to Twitter and follow us at PlayCraftLearn.
We are having a great time this year at the FETC conference here with the Minecraft team. If you are at FETC, don't forget to check out the Microsoft Education booth and learn everything that you can about how to bring this amazing new platform into your classrooms. On behalf of everybody here, my name is Jeff Bradbury, and we will see you guys on our next video.
You've been listening to the TeacherCast Educational Network, hosted by Jeff Bradbury. Please reach out to the show with all of your questions on Twitter at TeacherCast or online at www.teachercast.net. Be sure to subscribe to our podcast so you don't miss any future episodes. And please take a moment to write a review in the App Store.